Keeping up with their motto, let learning be a joy and teaching a pleasure, here we are with the remote teaching and learning process to bridge the gap. Happy learning to all students. Welcome, students. Today we will study history, chapter 4, the Vedic civilization. The Vedic period or Vedic age lies between 1500 BCE to 500 BCE. It is a period when Vedas were written. Now, the civilization that is based on Vedic literature is known as Vedic civilization. The Vedas are known as the earliest literature. Now, what exactly is literature? Let's see. See, literature can be any written or oral work that has a particular or specific language. Any written book or oral work cannot be called literature. It should have specific language. It reflects human life and society. For example, literature can be poetry, novels, short stories, epics like Ramayana, Mahabharata. So, here you can see in the picture the literature which is written in Sanskrit language. So, these Vedas were composed by many sages or rishis. Okay, some of the Vedic hymns were composed by women also. So hymns are religious songs or poems sung by people to praise God. Next is, Vedic literature is in Sanskrit language. And there are four Vedas, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharva Veda. Rig Veda is the older known Vedic Sanskrit text, or we can say scripture or book. It is in the form of verses. Now, what are verses? Verses are writings that have a specific rhythm or rhyme, like poems. Poems have rhymes like songs. So, verses are like stanzas or paragraph which have some proper rhythm. So, these Vedic texts and writings are known as Samhita also. So, we can say that such as Rig Veda Samhita, Yajur Veda Samhita, Sama Veda Samhita and Atharva Veda Samhita. Samhita means joined together or collection. So you can see that these scriptures are collection of various verses which are sung for the praise of God. Now the word Vedas is taken from the word Ved. Ved means to know and Vedas means knowledge. In this way we can say that these Vedas give us deep knowledge. Vedas are also called Shruti. Shruti is a Hindi word which means listen. So because they are passed on orally from one generation to another generation by Guru Shishya Parampara, that is why these Vedas are also called Shruti. Let's learn about these Vedic texts or Samhitas in detail. The first one is Rig Veda or Rig Veda Samhita. Each verse of the Veda is known as Richa. Okay, or verses. See, Richas are verses only. And when many Richas or number of Richas are put together to praise a deity or God, that poetic composition is called suktas. Okay, so don't get confused. Richas are verses, and when we put so many verses together, so many richas together, they are called suktas. Rig Veda has many suktas to praise different deities. Deities means idols of God, as you can see in this picture. See, here are different gods, and there are different suktas to praise all these different gods. Next is Yajurveda Samhita. The Yajurveda contains mantras which are uttered during a yajna. Yajna are fire sacrifices done using different mantras to please God. It was the tradition of Vedic time. This tradition of Vedic time is still followed in modern times. On various occasions, you must have seen people performing yajnas. So Yajurveda gives proper guidance about how the mantras should be chanted and when they should be chanted. In this picture, you can see verses written in Sanskrit. So this Yajurveda guides us when and how to chant these verses. This book includes the verses or poetic incantations and their explanation. Now, what is incantations? Incantations means words that have magical powers. So we can say that these verses were very powerful. Okay. Next is Samaveda Samhita. In this picture, you can see musical signs, and you must be thinking how these signs are related to Samveda. Let's see. See, Samveda teaches us how to sing. How to sing Rig Veda verses in a set of rhythm or tune at the time of Yajna. Because you cannot just utter them in any way. There is a proper way of singing them. It means, okay, then guidance for singing Rig Veda verses to a set of rhythmic tune, as I have explained. Next is contribution in the foundation of English Indian music. It means that Vedas were the base for the classical Indian music. Okay, so Sam Veda tells us how to sing the verses, and it also contributed in the foundation of Indian classical music. Let's move forward towards Atharva Veda. The name of Atharva Veda is kept after the name of Atharva Rishi. This Veda is different from other Vedas. How? Let's see. See, other three Vedas have different mantras and verses for the praise of God, but Atharva Veda is concerned with the activities of day-to-day life of the people. It gives solutions to deal with adversities and diseases. Adversities here means troubles or sufferings that we face. So it gives solution for that. Information about medicinal herbs. It also provides information about medicinal herbs. Medicinal herbs are plants that are used to cure any disease. So this was all about four Vedas. Next are the Brahmana texts, Aranyakas and Upanishad, which were written after these Vedas or Samhitas. Okay. Now, these Brahmanas texts, Aranyakas and Upanishads are also included in Vedic literature like Vedas. So what are Brahmana texts? Brahmana texts were composed or written to provide guidance about how to use the Vedic mantras in yajna rituals. Each Veda has, as we know that there are four Vedas, each Veda has its own Brahmana text. Next are Aranyakas. These scriptures or religious books talks about more about meditation rather than sacrifices. Okay. The rishis who lived in forests or jungles and meditation and do deep meditation, they used to write और एक्सप्रेस देयर थॉट्स इन दीज स्क्रिप्चर्स. दे यूज टू राइट देयर एक्सपीरियंसेस ऑल्सो. उपनिषद्स. सो दिस वर्ड इज मेड अप ऑफ टू वर्ड्स, उप विच मीन्स बाय, बी वाई बाय, एंड निषाद विच मीन्स सिटिंग down near. So we can understand from this that Upanishads indicates knowledge that the person acquired or get by sitting at the feet of the teacher. Upanishads also discuss serious and profound issues like life and death, because it is not easy to find answer to these questions. So in this way, the Vedic literature, the four Vedas, Brahmanas, Aranyakas and Upanishads were written over a period of 1500 years, and many changes took place in Vedic civilization, because there was later Vedic civilization and earlier Vedic civilization. So many changes took place, and Vedic literature gives us information about these changes. And also speaks about the day-to-day life in the Vedic period, how people used to live in that era. Okay, so let's revise what we have learned today. We have learned about Vedic civilization, Vedic literature, four Vedas, Rigved, Yajurved, Samved, Atharvaved, Brahmanas, Aranyakas and the Upanishads. And please watch this video carefully, and if any doubt, we will discuss in the class. Thank you. Thank you so much.